Hi everyone, and welcome back to a new game called Fate EXTELLA. And today we shall do something a little different. Instead of starting with the opening screen of the game, I shall show you the box. Yes, the premium box which I bought. And it looks pretty nice. The left is a card containing the product code that allows you to download a new dress, as you can see on the card itself, for both Alturia and Nero. Of which, I mean, I'm quite sure Arthur refers to Saber, but I've no idea who Nero is. And on the right is a tapestry that, you know, you hang up, it looks nice, and everyone's like, oh my god, you weep, and all that kind of BS. Yeah, screw those people. We like what we like, so there. And I'm pleased to tell you, as always, the packaging that this box came in was about 5 times the size of the box. Because, I don't know, Japan loves its packaging. That's something very normal. So upon opening this huge box, there is only, well, these two things in it. One is the game cartridge itself, and the other is a book which is so shiny that I can clearly see my reflection in it. And in this photo, you can clearly see, in the reflection, what is above my computer screen. I mean, wow, I could admire myself for hours using that book. However, I didn't open it, as you can see on the label in the middle, that there's a warning that it contains spoilers. So, I'm not really fond of spoilers, so I think I'll just leave it as that. Besides, it also says the one ring for the true king, the one ring to rule them all, the one ring to find them, the one ring to bring them all in the darkness bind them, and what results is a nice SM orgy. So now, that's the brief unboxing done with, let us now go on to the game. Now, before we start, I admit, a lot like Macross, I haven't really followed much of the Fate Stay Night series. I did play the first game a bit, and then I watched the adaptation by Studio Deen, which I'm sure many people have mixed feelings about. But damn, this music is nice. And this background is really beautiful. Although I'm not too sure where we are standing, you know, be it in the sky or the water or something like that. Nevertheless, I have high hopes for going into this game, and I'm sure that Marvelous will not disappoint. Alright, so let us start. Choose your gender. There's no two ways about it, okay? let us just be ourselves and choose the male gender. Because you know what they say? There is never a real girl online. Nope, totally not. And when you think about it is indeed a ridiculous idea. Difficulty? Of course normal. I mean easy? Don't be a wussy. So anyway, like I was saying, yeah. There's no way there's a girl online. Much less 3 or 4 girls, of which all but one are pretty well endowed. Yeah, no such thing. And let's not even get started on online wives. So anyway, I'm going into this game blind, as usual, because, I only know the so-called original characters, like, you know, the first Saber, Lancer, and all the people. And from what I see, there are several Sabers, several Assassins, and so on and so forth. Okay, I didn't watch Fate Zero or the other series, so I'm kind of ignorant as to who is who. But hey, when I saw that, you know, this game was by Marvelous, I was like, shut up and take my money. Because think about it. The original Fate Stay Night and all the other series by Type Moon were originally H novels. And then they have a tie-in with a company like Marvelous who makes series like, Senran Kagura and Valkyrie Drive, where there's lots of gynexing and male gaze and strategic shots. You know you have a winning formula. Okay, that's not all there is to it, okay? Marvelous does make very good action games. Like the aforementioned 2 and even Uppers. So I do have high hopes in this game, and I'm pretty sure that Marvelous does a good job out of it. Although, well, I'm not sure why did Uppers not do so well. I thought it was a great game. It must have been all the feminists, I'm sure. Moving on. Main story, sub story, I guess it's all the side stories. Free battle, and gallery, which understandably there is nothing in it because we haven't really started the game yet. Let's look at servants. Ah yes, Saber. You look much different. Another saber. Ruler? Was it such a servant? I don't know. Okay, I really don't know. Archer, yes. Another saber. Rider. As you can see, I'm like totally, I have no idea what everything is. I'm just playing it because I want to see oh. Man, you know you've got a winning combination when your skirt is see-through. So who can we start with? Only Saber. Who is known for eating ridiculous amounts of food, especially rice. Mainly because her master is kind of like, does not know how to transfer magic from his ass to her. Man, that sounds pretty wrong, but you know what I mean. Okay, let's skip all this because I'm lazy to see the story. I just want to get into the action, come on. Because that is what Marvelous games are all about. Action. Gainaxing. Physics. Long loading times. Although, I gotta say, not as long as D3 Publisher, you know. Sometimes their loading time is ridiculously long. Nice. This is one hell of a starting point. Cool, I like this. Okay, so anyway, the instructions here are like L to move and R to change the camera, which we have done already. Square for normal attack and triangle for like strong attack, which I mean, man, I gotta say she's really kicking ass here. Yeah, X is the jump and R is the dash. Kind of pretty standard. I mean, if you play enough Marvelous games, I'm sure you know all this. Which is a nice thing, you know. I mean, I don't like those companies. Oh, what's this? I don't like those companies who like change their controls in every single game because I don't know. They feel that their audience needs something new every time, which honestly is a whole load of hogwash. Wow. Wow. Okay, for one thing, that doesn't really look like Saber from the original art, and that doesn't. Wow, that was really flashy. And I gotta say, that doesn't look like Saber from the original drawings by Type Moon. Well, but then again, I guess I'm nitpicking. And neither does that sound like Kawasumi Ayako, you know, the original voice actress. But then again, the sound is a little. It sounds a little muffled. Is my volume correct? Yeah, my volume is the maximum. That could be a problem with the game. And now we have the opening movie. And in order to avoid copyright claims? Man, what's wrong with my tongue today? Anyway, in order to avoid copyright claims, I will attempt to talk over this thing for about the next 1.5 minutes. I mean, I'm serious. The record companies in Japan are pretty zealous about it. If you remember not too long ago, one of my Macross videos had to be muted because Victor Entertainment did a copyright claim on my video like less than a day after it was released. Although, you know, there was a sounds of fighting in the background and me talking, but no, you cannot have that music in the background. So, yeah, sorry about that. And it was quite a pity because it was a pretty nice song, just like this one here. So let's see, what was my last contact with Fate/stay night? I remember it was actually a doujin, you know, the self-published works that I got during Comic Con 89 last year. The whole premise of the series was Saber and, well, the other characters of Fate Stay Night from the original Fate Stay Night series, watching themselves from the Fate Hollow series, you know, on TV, and their corresponding reactions. And honestly, that doujin was actually pretty good. You see the characters get into all sorts of weird antics, like imitating what they are doing on screen. And one of the parts which I really liked was Archer smiling, you know, because he rarely smiles. And Toh Sakurai like going all ballistic and saying, "Do it again, smile again." And the actual Archer next to her was like, "What? I have no idea what you're saying." Or the part where Shido was telling Rin that, you know, "You're my best partner" and all that, and Sakura getting all depressed and stuff. And after that going all yandere on him. It's really awesome, seriously. Insert name here. See, default. Jeez, I've no idea who is this. But we'll go with it anyway, because I'm too lazy to think of a name. And besides, I think forever to think of a name. It can be like a 5-minute exercise for me. So, you know, usually if they give me a default name, I'll just go with it. So that I don't waste time and I can get straight into the action. Come on, let's skip all this story. I want to get straight into the action. And besides, all this looks pretty cool.
どうだ?これがヨと
We have already ascertained that this is not Saber, and therefore, it's okay that the voice actress is different. So now, what do we do? Talk. Settings. Craft items. Closet. Rest. What's in the closet? Oi. As you've seen at the beginning of this episode, I got it from the the premium box set. It came with this dress for two characters, one which is her, and the other I cannot remember what's her name. And the other DLC was some other character who looked extremely serious, you know, the SRS serious kind of people. So, I like this. Now, important thing, when it comes to Marvelous Games, you know that there's lots of gynexing. So, does the touchscreen work? I know it's kind of like a frivolous thing to think about, but hey, it's Marvelous Games after all. And the touchscreen doesn't... I'm not getting any reaction out of her. Maybe only in the closet, like, you know, in Senran Kagura, the communication room. And unfortunately, it doesn't seem to work here. Jeez, my touchscreen doesn't work. Marvelous Entertainment, return me half my money. Nah, I'm just kidding. We have more important things to do now. No wonder the volume is so low. Why is everything set to 4? Done. Now we should be able to hear them talk. Blah blah blah. Okay, these are fine. Let's hear. I want to hear her talk. Oh crap. Maybe we should have read the story. Let's just choose the first option.
So,
ここは月なのだ。地上から遠く離れた天に浮かぶディアーネの星。
Fantastic! I can finally hear them speak. And I gotta say, I like the detail that Marvelous has put into this game. Because you notice that right now, her dress corresponds to what we changed her into just now. Same for previously before we changed her into this dress. I like it that they made the effort to have the artwork reflect what the characters are wearing. I think it's a nice touch. Anyway, skip the story. Come on, I want to get fighting. What do I have to do? Okay, fine, rest.
いやもう話したいことがたんまりとあるが。
What's that ring? I don't see any ring. Maybe it's that thing that was shining on her finger just now?
気になるか?気になるであろう。
Yes, we want to know. Come on, just tell us already.
喜んでほしい。これこそは聖杯戦争の勝者の特権。ムーンセルから譲渡された王のレガリア。セラフを支配する王権の証。世が史上最高の皇帝であることを示す唯一無二の宝石なのだ。
I appreciate the fact that you are really excited about that.Then again, it is a mark of having won the previous Holy Grail War. So, how should we reply? The first reply is, ooh, shiny. Okay, minus the shiny part. It's more of like, I'm really impressed. Ooh, that kind. And the second option is, oh, it's pretty. You know, the kind of nonchalant answer. Let's not be such a wet blanket and let's choose the first answer.
いかん。とにかく今は休息をとって